In this video, I'll be taking one more example on loop. In my last video, I have defined what is loop and in which situation loop arrive and how to apply it after UV method if the Zij minus Cij does not turn out to be all less than or equal to zero for a minimization transportation problem. Now, let us consider here is that it has been already given that there is an initial allocations are already given to us. So, we don't need to apply northwest least cost method or Vogel's approximation method. Initial allocation is already given to us and the question is only about is it an optimal solution to the transportation problem or not. So that means I only need to apply UV method to check Zij minus Cij, and if it is not optimal, then modify it to the optimal solution. So now let us make this table again and let's check the UV method. So let's find the solution of this problem, and in the first iteration I'm just going to allocate whatever be the allocation given in the table. So it says x in the question x13 is 50 units. So here x13, this is 50 units, and then I have x14, this is 20 units. That makes a total of 70 which is available. This is 55, here it is 90, and the demand is 85. This is 35, 50 and 45. And then what else are availability given to us is x21, which is 55. Then I have x31, this is 30, and x32, this is 35. So that makes all our constraints satisfied. And in the last, there has to be one more, x34, that is 25. So there are total allocations given to us and I have allocated here. Now in the first iteration I need to check what is ui vj for this particular solution. So let me to calculate u1 u2 u3 and we will calculate v1 v2 v3 and v4 for all of them. Again I'm just taking randomly u3 equal to 0. If u3 is 0, so applying the standard formula for the basic variable, we know for basic variable ui plus vj should be equal to cij. So this is for basic cells in fact, and we know these the cells which I have circled with the green color and there are allocation, these are basic cells. So I'm going to make the allocation as u1 plus v3 should be equal to the cost 9, and because we have started from u3, so u3 plus v4 should be equal to the cost 7. So v4 is 7, and continuing like this we find all the other allocations. We have explained in our earlier videos how to calculate these ui. So here I'm just directly writing because we want to see how loops come and we want to see the different shapes of the loop in this particular problem. Now once I've calculated all the uij, I need to now calculate the net evaluations. So for net evaluation we use the formula for non-basic cell, for non-basic cells or non-basic variables we want to calculate Zij minus Cij value, which is ui plus vj minus Cij. So here this value is calculated and this value is 0, next value is 7, this value is 8, 12, and then we got 0, and here we got 9. Now we put theta in most positive. So what is the most positive here is 12. So you put theta over here, and then we need to identify which are the basic cells through which I can make a loop starting from theta and ending to theta. So here loop does not need to have a square shape, so we just need to trace. We may follow up any direction. So suppose I take this as 50, it cannot go in the left hand side because there are no basic cells. So it will turn to a basic cell 20, and then it will come down to 25. Then if I stop the cell at 35, I don't have these cells which are in the these two columns. There are no cells from 35, I cannot make a turn. So what I'll do is I'll take a cell here and then I will take to 55 this cell and I will come back. So this is the loop, and then we need to put up the sign. So at theta it is always plus, at theta it is always plus, and then alternatively apply a negative sign. So here it is negative 50 minus 20 plus, then 25 minus, and then 30 plus, and then 55 minus, or and from since 55 negative, so theta back to plus. So this goes to the loop. So this makes the whole loop, and now we want to find out what is the value for theta. So in this particular case, theta is the minimum of the negative allocations, negative signed allocations. So which means theta is the minimum of 50, 25 and 55. So I am just putting the allocations where I have put it the negative sign. Like this one, 25 comes at negative, 50 comes at negative, and 55 comes at negative. So theta is the value that is 25. So in the second iteration, I am going to make this table again, and I am going to again apply UI VJ. So that's the second iteration. Take theta as 25 because we have allocated something here. And I'm going to subtract from 50. So that makes 50 minus 25. This 20 plus 25, that will make 45. This 25, this will become non-basic cell in next iteration. Become non-basic cell in this table. In this table. So here, this is non-basic cell. And this 30 plus 25, this makes it 55. This 35 is not a part of loop, so I'll keep it as it is 35. 55 minus 25, here I have now the allocation 30. So there are again, we have the total of 6 allocation. And now again, I calculate UI VJ. So once I calculate UI VJ in the similar process as I have calculated earlier, we will see what are the allocations and so once I calculate UI VJ in the similar process, we'll see where we are going to put theta or the current Zij minus Cij is optimal. Now in this table also, there are some positive Zij minus Cij, and we can see the most positive is 19. So we put a theta here, and again, we are going to find the loop. Now in this case, either we can move to 25. So that is fine because moving to 45, there is no basic cell. So from here 25, we can come back to this 25. We can go to this 35. We can go to 55. We can come to 35. And from 35, we can go back directly to back to theta. So this is a loop. We have started from this theta, which is plus. This is minus. This is plus. Then from here, we have turned it here negative. This is plus. And then we have a minus sign and back to plus. So this is the loop. And here, what is the value for theta? Theta is minimum of negative value. So that means theta is 25, 30 and 35. So the minimum value is 25. So in the third iteration, we see here now, in place of this theta, in this cell, I am going to allocate 25. And this particular cell now becomes a non-basic. So now, this cell is non-basic. So we subtract this theta quantity from here and it becomes a zero. So actually this is going to leave. The minimum is going to leave now. This 25 plus 25, so this will make 50. This 45 was out of loop, but it remains in the basis cell. And then we have 35 minus, so this is 5. 55 plus 20, so that makes it as 80. 35 minus 20, this makes it as 10. And we continue the process in the similar way, and we see that after the again applying UI VJ, we get this as the. Now in the third iteration, we see that here is the theta. In the similar manner, you calculate UI VJ. And if I look at the fourth iteration, again, I see this as the loop that has started from this cell. This is theta here. And we could have calculated in the usual way, we can verify. So I've just directly now written U3 is equal to 11, V1 is equal to minus 1, V2 is equal to 1, V3 is equal to minus 2, and V4 equal to 3. Now in the similar process, we can find the third, fourth and fifth iteration. And we see there in the third and fourth iteration, we still require a loop, and that loop can be identified again from the most positive Zij minus Cij. But in the fifth iteration, we see all the Zij minus Cij here in this table. Zij minus Cij is negative for non-basic variable. And for basic variable, it is always 0. So, I mean, this condition is true for every I and j. So, this means the current table is optimal. And for the optimal value, we can multiply this 30 with the SOCs 1. This quantity was 3. This is 5. This quantity is 2. This is 10 and 12. So, this is we don't require because it's a non-basic cell. This one is 7. So, you multiply the corresponding allocation Cij with Xij. That gives me 11 and 60, and this is my optimal solution. So this question gives you a lot of exposure about how to write the loop and how to obtain the optimal solution of a transportation problem if loops come in the picture.